Howdy, banger pals. Blaine Smith joining you for another Overkill Reviews, Banger's weekly metal review show. What do we got this week? Well, DK hates it. I love it. Let's have a listen. There we go. It's the new album from Imperial Triumphant called Spirit of Ecstasy, out today, July 22nd, on Century Media Records. So who are Imperial Triumphant? Well, Imperial Triumphant are New York. They've been New York since they formed in 2005. They're New York visually in that they perform as these golden, glittering, Art Deco-masked skyscrapers that always look disinterested. They're New York sonically in that they're a unique blend of avant-garde jazz and metal in the same spirit as 70s no-wavers like James Chance blended avant-garde jazz and punk. And they're New York in that there are too many goddamn people. The core of the band is only three people, but there's almost a dozen guest artists on this record, ranging from our banger pal Alex Skolnick, Voivod Snake, all the way up to Kenny. Yes, that one, G. So, they're New York. How much of this record is Brooklyn, and how much of this record is Staten Island? Let's find out. And we know you want to find out because we have a Patreon campaign where you get to vote on what records we cover every month, as long as a bunch of other perks. And this was a big pick with y'all, so let's get into it. So our first point up is Chaos, which is something you've probably come to expect with Imperial Triumphant, but as per each release, we once again need to recalibrate our expectations of the level of chaos we're getting, and there's a big step here that might once again warrant changing the old genre tags on metal archives from neoclassical black metal early to avant-garde technical black metal, death metal later to, I don't know, aggressive dark jazz, metallic no wave, postmodernism, or the cultural logic of late capitalism by Frederick Jameson. Regardless, if you're coming here for straight metal, you will be disappointed. But if your enjoyment of Imperial Triumphant comes from their constant recalibration and pushing the limits of what's music, then good news. Guests. Yes, this is in big part due to the staggering number of guest musicians on the album, but I think the fact that Imperial Triumphant are never overpowered by this many, especially very senior musicians, really speaks to the strength of the band. I mean, off the top, that video I showed you has Kenny G and Kenny G's son, who also frequently collaborates with the band, and you might not even know if someone didn't tell you. The only time you really notice anyone else on the record for sure is when frequent collaborator Yoshiko Ohara starts screaming, but that's because she's a Japanese lady, and you know that these are not three Japanese ladies. But then quickly they switch back to kind of a normal Imperial Triumphant space, and it's great. Let's enjoy a little clip of that together. We come to our first negative point, which is time. Imperial Triumphant do not value your time. People think New Yorkers are always in a hurry, but sometimes they're in a hurry to get to $20 bottomless mimosa brunch, only to accidentally get zoiled midday, pass out at 8 p.m., and still wake up 20 minutes late for work. There's no better example of this than Bezamanaya, which is the penultimate track on the album, where the first 3.5 minutes of it is, I don't know, like a Russian guy talking, and then the last minute of the song is some plinky plink. More frustratingly is that there's almost always a payoff there. Just like when I was talking about that drunk bruncher, you probably pictured someone hot and fun. The great moments are really, really great. Whether that's a more sane Alex Skolnick guitar moment on Pleasure of Their Company, or the bubbling, blackened, deathy, absolute evil in between the parts I was complaining about on Buzmanyana. Have a listen. Though I don't know how this album cover slipped through Imperial Triumphant's normal strict attention to aesthetic detail, because it's dog shit. It's weird to make cover a big point, but this is a very aesthetic band from the three music videos they released to go with this. The way they perform, everything is really calculated and perfect, and then this! What is this? They took this great photo of this opulent woman holding one of their masks, and then dropped it on some bootleg Klimt background with glow? Fucking glow? I'd say it looks like one of the promos I make for our Twitch stream, because we have a Twitch stream, twitch.tv/bangertv. Come on out, Lockhorns is back. But I would have the common decency to not put glow on an album cover. I mean, and then send it out the door like that's okay. How much money does this thing cost? There's deluxe package. I think this is a very big record for Imperial Triumphant, because if I was trying to describe what it sounds like, I'd have to say something like, it's Voivod meets James Chance meets Merzbow meets Ruins meets. And when you're putting that many meets in there, it's probably because it doesn't sound like anything meets anything. It just sounds like Imperial Triumphant. This is really kind of the distillation of all they've been working towards to kind of really emerge as this is a truly singular band. I wish we could get some of the urgency from Abyssal Gods back, but outside of that, truly a very impressive work of creativity, originality, and freedom on display here. This is a band really venturing outside of the genre borders to try and find new fertile ground, and I think even if you don't like this, it'll have a very positive and beneficial effect to metal generally as a whole. So love it or hate it, you gotta respect it. And that's why I'm giving the album 4 out of 5 skulls that are wearing the Imperial Triumphant masks, but not that mask from the cover with the fucking glow on it. Are you? So thanks for coming out. We're playing a bit with a new format. We're trying to keep Overkill Reviews fresh for you. What did you think of the review? What did you think of the album? Talk about it. What's going on? What's shaking? You know, I'll be down in the comments with you below. Thanks for coming out. Hope to see you on the next one. Peace out, gang. Take care.